Have you seen articles in different websites, and have you seen different astrologers in your village, in your city, in your town, or in your metro, or in your country, and in YouTube? Whenever they see that a planet is combust, or it's afflicted, or it is debilitated, they will say that, oh yeah, this planet is having problem, you know. But have you seen that if you ask them a counter question, that what is the problem? How do you differentiate the problems which can come because of combustion? First of all, is it a problem? If yes, then what kind of a problem it is? If a planet is combust, what are the challenges? Or are there challenges at all? And if a planet is debilitated, then what happens? Or if a planet is afflicted, how do you know if a planet is afflicted? How do you know to what extent it is afflicted? How do you know that is it afflicted to that extent that it is going to cause some serious problem in my life? Because always the malefics will have conjunctions and aspects through which they afflict. Always some planet or the other will be combust, especially Mercury and Venus, because they are very near to the sun always. Or some planet will be debilitated. So, just if we make a statement that, okay, my Mercury is debilitated, so it's useless. Is it going to help us like that? Alright, so this video is very important to clarify those miscommunications which have been happening, unfortunately, through YouTube and many other astrologers. Okay, so if you are new, then please like, comment, share and subscribe. And if you want a consultation, go down to the link. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and He will help you to understand and get over the effects of an afflicted, debilitated or combust planet. Alright, so the sun is the first. So let's talk of combustion. So what is combustion? Oh, by the way, I have a video on combustion. If you want to watch that, you can go to my channel and type combustion, you will find. So what is combustion basically? Combustion basically means that a planet is very close to the sun. Alright, so then if you Google in YouTube or if you find articles, they will say combust planet means there are problems. Let's take the example of Venus. So suppose Venus is combust in your chart, then they will say, oh, you will have problems in your married life. But the question is, what kind of problems? There can be so many problems. There can be problems in getting married. There can be problems in finding a person. And after finding, due to some reason or the other, you are not able to get married. Then it can happen that you find somebody and you get married. But then the marriage is not possible to sustain. Or it can happen that there are certain things within the marriage which you cannot change. By change, I don't mean you try to change the partner. But there are some conditions which are put by some other people, like the father-in-law, the mother-in-law, your son, your daughter or anybody or some relative. And somehow you are not able to. It's like somebody has written something and given it to you. So whenever you read about combust Venus or any planet which is combust, you have to understand what exactly combustion is. Otherwise, you will not understand what the problems are. So now what exactly happens when a planet is combust? Now there are different debates on this regarding the degrees of combustion. So some say that there are different degrees, like they say for some planets it is 5 degrees, some planets it is 2 degrees, some planets it is 8 degrees, some planets it is within 12 degrees, some say if it is within 8 to 12 it is in Deeptamsha, and some say okay, to the degree it is close, to that degree it will have the effects. Alright, but the major outlook is that if it is beyond 12 degrees, then it is not combust. in general, that's the opinion. Now suppose your sun is at 25 degrees and suppose your sun is at 25 degrees of Aries and suppose your Mercury is in 5 degrees of Taurus. Now you will say that, oh, both are not conjunct, so there's no combustion, but Mercury can still be combust because 25 degrees of Aries and 5 degrees of Taurus is only 10 degree difference. There's only 10 degrees, although they are in a different sign. So Mercury can still be combust there. Alright, so do not think that a planet is not in the same sign, so it is not combust. You have to check the degrees. So on a broader spectrum, after asking many people and talking to many other astrologers, what I have found is that, and in my experience also, around 12 degrees, if it is there, then within that, then the combustion is acting, which means you will actually feel the heat. So now the question is, what exactly happens in combustion? See, what is combustion? It's close to the sun. Who is sun? Sun is Lord Ram, basically. Lord Vishnu's avatar, which is connected to the solar dynasty, the sun planet, is Lord Ram because he is Suryavanshi. So Lord Ram's life, if you want to know combustion, that you have to know how Lord Ram's life was. So it's essential that we read the Ramayana for that. So what happened in his case? There were many sacrifices which he had to make. And his life was very much regulated. Regulated means, his father said that, I gave a promise to Keke that whatever she asks, I will fulfill. And now she wants that you go to the forest for 14 years and Bharat becomes the king instead of you. And then Lord Ram said, okay. Of course, I mean, Dashrath did not say that, but Keke said that this is what I want your father to do. And then when Lord Ram heard it, he said, okay. So that's the first thing that can happen in combustion. There can be some restriction which is put on you pertaining to that planet. And it can happen that you are forced to follow that restriction. Restriction doesn't mean that it's necessarily bad, but there can be something of which you do not have any control. And that will play in your life. Then what happened? Sita Devi was kidnapped. I mean, Sita Devi was not kidnapped by Ravan. The Maya Sita, which was actually Vedvati, she was being kidnapped by Ravan. And then he had to fight a war. So this is another thing which can happen in combustion. You might have to fight certain areas regarding that planet. Now, what it is and what not, that will depend on the horoscope. Which planet is combust? Which house is it ruling? Then later on, because of social customs, because the king has to set the right standard, so he had to stay away from Sita Devi. But the point is, he did not marry later on. Sita Devi did not marry. He also did not marry. This is the next thing that can happen during combustion. You might be forced to let go of certain aspects of that planet. That can happen. And of course, that these things are all because of purification. Purification means, because sun is a very hot planet. Hot doesn't mean temperature wise, that's obvious. But hot means it is purifying the karma. So this is another thing which can happen in combustion. Now the next thing that can happen during combustion is anything. See, Lord Ram is also, he's also the sun. So sun is what? King, the government, right? And anything you do which breaks the law of the government, you will get punished. So suppose your fourth lord is combust, any planet it can be, suppose it's the fourth lord, then anything you do related to your mother, suppose you try to do some politics, anything nefarious you try to do, you will be punished. Without a doubt it will happen. Take it in writing. Seventh lord is combust. You try to cheat on your spouse, you will be punished severely. Severe punishment will be there. Because it's like saying, Lord Ram is standing there. So whatever you do, because see, the sun is like, it's light everywhere. So you cannot cheat the sun. And breaking the law means you do something, not only cheating, it can be anything. You try to pull that person down. You try to show that that person is inferior to you. So when you do all this, then you will face immediate repercussion. Especially I have seen people who have a combust Venus. And especially I have seen this in a man's chart. You say anything to your wife which you should not have said, then that day itself she will leave and she will throw you out of her life. And then you have to go and fall at her feet and you have to beg, please forgive me, please come back to my life. But she will not come back. One mistake you do, that's it. And the next thing is, those days kings used to marry many ladies because there was a considerable amount of male population who would go to the forest. They would become brahmacharis and sannyasis. So the number of women who were unmarried were much higher. So kshatriyas, the kings, would give shelter and protection to other ladies by that, by marrying them. That was not for sexual indulgence or sexual enjoyment. But in case of Lord Ram, he only married once. Eka Patni Vrat he had taken. So in case of combustion, the same thing can happen. We will have to follow a very straight path. If you try to deviate much, you will be punished. So suppose any planet, if it is combust, you try to break the norms related to that planet, you will be punished. You try to do something which that person does not like, or which others are doing which should not be done, but you are doing because others are doing, you will be punished. That's what is combustion. So if you understand the life of Lord Ram, you will understand what combustion is. And this becomes very important because many times planets are combust, right? So you have to analyze accordingly. You have to see the what are the natural significations of that planet. Then you have to see which houses the planet is ruling. And at times during combustion, you might have to do things even if you don't like. You have to do it as a rule. You have to do it as a law. That can happen. So these are the problems that can come from combustion. The next thing is affliction. Affliction means when any planet is either conjunct or aspected by a natural malefic. Who are the natural malefics? Sun, Mars, Saturn, Rahu, Ketu. So any planet which is conjunct, and among these also, if they are conjunct with each other, then also they are considered afflicted. So suppose Mars is conjunct Saturn. So Mars is afflicting Saturn, Saturn is afflicting Mars. So what is affliction? Affliction basically means that suppose there is an aspect, mutual aspect, okay, Saturn and Venus, suppose, because that's most frequently asked by people, because in this world people come to astrology because of two reasons, relationships and money. So if you talk of Saturn Venus conjunction or mutual aspect, So then what happens? Venus is there. Forget where Venus is, how Venus is, it is exalted, debilitated, whatever it is. So suppose it is aspected by Saturn. So Saturn aspects the 3rd, 7th and 10th house from wherever it sits. And it's a natural malefic. So wherever Saturn sees through aspect, he will put a pause in those houses. Pause means it's like saying to open that house, you need 10 times more the effort or 100 times or million times more. So that is why you will always see people who have Saturn and Venus linked or Saturn associated with the 7th house. Even for Cancer and Leo Lagnas, because Saturn itself rules the 7th house for these two Lagnas. You can see that if you take a percentage, depending on the other combinations, you will always see Saturn conjunct Venus or Saturn Venus aspecting each other. Or Saturn alone aspecting Venus. They will always have delays in marriage. Now, if they have a great 7th house, the Upapada is fine and all this, then that may not happen. Or if around the age of 21, 22, your 2nd house, 7th house or 11th house or 5th or 9th. Because these are houses of marriage. 2, 5, 7, 9 and 11. Especially 2, 7 and 11. And best is the 11th house. So suppose these houses are getting active, then the delay may not happen. But in most of the cases, it's not necessary that it happens like that. So most of the times, people can get married in 30s or 40s if Saturn and Venus are linked. Now, why that happens? That is affliction. Affliction means there is a planet like Venus who is having its natural significations. Now, affliction means there's another planet which is coming and interfering in its free space in case of Venus here. So Venus wants to give you love, romance, marriage and relationship. But Saturn is telling, I will not let you give that. Because you have to see some suffering in this area. Why? Because you gave suffering to others. Saturn is the Karaka for the 6th, 8th and 12th houses primarily, apart from the 10th house. So what is 6th house? 6th house is delays, setbacks. So if Saturn associates with Venus or 7th house or the 7th lord, you will see there is delays and disappointments in marriage. You may not be able to marry somebody who you love. Yes, 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 that can happen. You love somebody but that person says no to you. That could be the case. No, I mean, that person says no, but I can't marry you due to some reason. Some reason or the other. Then it's the Karaka for the 8th house. 8th house means reversals. You expect something and something else happens. 8th house means you have to do it again. You see what happens when you go to a ticket to collect tickets to any place. And then they say, oh, ticket counter is closed because 8th house is death, right? Death means that thing is closed. So he will tell, the TT will tell you, oh, come tomorrow. So you have wasted time, right? So there will be reversals if Saturn and Venus are linked. Then 12th house, loss. You lose somebody who you love. Yes. And 10th house. 10th house is responsibility. From the day you are married, your wife or your husband is like, oh, you didn't do that, you have to do this. Too much responsibility. Then what is Mars? Mars shows violence. Too much arguing, bickering on unnecessary issues. That's what Mars is. If it is badly placed, provided. So suppose Mars is associating with the 7th house or Venus. Then these things can happen. You get married and then you are going on fighting all the time. Yes. And then Sun is also malefic. So that's what combustion, that's what Sun does. That I have already explained. Now what Rahu does? Rahu gives you this belief that Rahu associating with Mercury, suppose. It gives you this belief that you do not have enough money. Even if you get all the wealth of the universe, you will still keep getting that feeling. So Rahu deprives you of peace. So Rahu will tell you that, look, you are not happy because you don't have this. Have you seen people getting obsessed with goals and destinations rather than the process? People say that, I am not happy because I am not married. So the moment I get married, I'll become happy. Then they say, I am not happy because I don't have a child. The moment I have a child, I'll become happy. I am not happy because I don't have a job. The moment I get a job, I'll become happy. I am not happy because I don't have a home. So the moment I take a home, I'll be happy. Or if I take a car, I'll be happy. These things can happen when Rahu is associating. And Ketu. Ketu, what it does is, Ketu is very interesting. Ketu tells you that without doing spiritual practices related to that planet, you will not be happy. Or in worst case, it will put you in comfort zone. Ketu and Venus linked sometimes, I've seen. Highly responsible in relationships. Oh, the spouse is there. Forget it. And then your wife is going on having affairs with somebody. And you are wondering what happened. Highly responsible behavior. Jupiter and Mars, if they are linked, this is what I have seen. Always bickering fights with the children. Alright, so this is the meaning of affliction, that a planet is there, but its natural signification is been hindered. There is a hindrance to that. And now the question is, when will you feel the effects of affliction very strongly? The answer is, if a planet is afflicted by more than one malefic. So suppose your Venus is conjunct both Mars and Saturn, or it has been afflicted by Mars and afflicted by Saturn. Or suppose it is conjunct Rahu and aspected by Saturn. So then in that case, you will feel because then what happens is, it's like saying that not only one malefic is aspecting and the another one is also trying. So then whenever you activate that area, you feel as if like life is like a curse. So in that case, we have to do serious remedies for that planet, depending on the sign and the house and all these. All right. Otherwise, if that planet is not remedied, then life can feel like a curse sometimes. And if three malefics are aspecting or conjunct, then that will be much, much more. All right. So that is what is affliction. And what Mars does is, Mars will give you a feeling that you are always right in that area. So Mars, Venus, people, they always keep fighting. Why? Because they always feel that I am always right. You are wrong. I am right, you see. So then there's fighting, there is bickering. These things can happen, Mars and Venus. Mars and Jupiter, I've always seen this. Always bickering is going on with children. And depending on which house the affliction is, when those planets get activated in their dasha, that is the time the suffering will come. Okay? So that is what is about affliction. Then, what is debilitation? Debilitation means, the word Parashara uses, nicha, nicha vastha. So it means that a planet is at its lowest dignity. Suppose, because that's planetary dignity, right? Friend sign, own sign, exaltation, mool trikon, debilitation. So suppose a planet is in debility, then they say ki it's in the least dignity. So suppose you go to somebody and they say that, oh, I met the CEO of this company, he's very dignified. Or I met this CEO of this company, she's very dignified. Which means, dignified means what? Dignified means that person is doing what the person is supposed to do. That person is exactly doing what that person should do. But suppose you said, oh, that person is not dignified. That means that person either is not doing what he is supposed to do or he is doing exactly the opposite. Debilitation means we have not focused on that planet. It means that we are confused regarding that planet. Or if it's debilitated and if it's afflicted or if it is more severe and if it is an adusthana, then it can happen that that is causing a lot of harm to us in our life. So, debilitation means there is zero awareness about that planet. Exaltation means there is very high level of awareness. Anybody who has an exalted planet, anywhere in the chart, forget the house. You talk anything regarding that planet, you will see they will start smiling. Anybody who has an exalted Venus, you go and talk to them. Especially if it is near 28 degrees of Pisces, where the peak exaltation of Venus is there. You go and talk to that person about marriage, love, relationships, creativity, paint, arts. Person will be like, oh yeah, you know, that's very important in life. Because that person is totally aware of those significations. The person can feel when the person sees that couple are kissing and embracing each other, then that person feels 10 times, oh my God, I wish I also had somebody like them. But if it is debilitated, you may be like, oh, let them do what they are doing. So exalted does not mean it is good or it's great. It only means that you are aware of the planet. You are aware of the Karakatvas. Exalted Saturn. You are aware of the fact that there should be discipline in your life. There should be hard work. There should be commitment. Exalted Sun. You should have a purpose in life. Debilitated Sun. No purpose in life. Roaming headlessly. Or purpose comes after a lot of setbacks in life. These things can happen. And of course, there are different degrees for exaltation. So you have to see that also. Okay, so that is how you differentiate between a combust planet, an afflicted planet, and a debilitated planet. Alright, and if a planet is exalted and it is afflicted, the misery is 10 times more. Because it's like saying, suppose Venus is exalted but it is afflicted by Saturn and Rahu. So Rahu will give you cheating. Rahu will give you partners who will cheat you, and Saturn will say that, oh, I will give you tears, and then your Venus is exalted. So whenever you hear or you see anything related to movies or love or sex, you feel it 10 times. Oh my God, I want this, I want this, I need this. And then Saturn Rahu is telling, we will not let you have it. So then you feel 10 times more miserable because your awareness is very high. So there you go. If you have an exalted planet but it is afflicted, the problem is 10 times more. Because if a planet is debilitated, you are like, I am not too much interested in that. But generally it doesn't happen like this. What happens is, I have seen charts where Venus is in Virgo and Moon is also in Virgo. So Venus and Moon are together. So that's like two benefits together. So it's opposite of affliction. So there's a lot of happiness and that desire for enjoyment if Moon and Venus are together. So now suppose Rahu is throwing the fifth aspect from somewhere. Another earth sign, suppose Taurus. Suppose Rahu is in Taurus. And then suppose Saturn is in Pisces. Classic combination. So planet is debilitated, Venus, Moon are in Virgo. So the awareness is less and it's afflicted, but it is conjunct Moon, benefic. So it becomes very difficult to study the charts that time. Alright, and most of the times it happens like this. You will never find an exalted planet which is free from affliction via conjunction or aspect. And you will never find a debilitated planet which is aspected by malefics which are not conjunct other benefics. That you will never find in a chart. Very rarely you will find it. Alright, so this is how you study the differences between all these three. So whenever next time you are reading charts of clients and your friends, your family members, anybody, and you see that a planet is combust, afflicted or debilitated, you have to explain them what is the meaning. Just don't say, oh, it's bad. Venus is combust, it's bad. No, it's not bad. You have to explain what is the difference. Alright, so long video as usual. Thank you very much. If you like this video, click the thumbs up. And if you're new, then like, comment, share and subscribe. And if you want a consultation, please go down to the link below. Okay, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. Tata.